Anyone else with an imperative thought or question? Anyone, anything they want to share with the rest of the group? That's what you want to share? What's up, man? That's actually a funny story. We played that song, Play Crack the Sky, before, and I know most of the song, well, not on the last record, but before that, a lot of song titles were just nods or inside jokes to things or whatnot, but there used to be this Christian metal band. I went to Christian school when I was younger, and so all my, like, I was into music that my parents were listening to and stuff my sister was listening to, so I was in, like, seventh grade when Nirvana came around. Luckily, that broke all of our spirits, and that's all we listened to. But before that, you know, me and John Nolan, who was my classmate, and my friend Tim, they were John's dad was a pastor, so he was only into, like, Christian metal and like Believer and Petra and One Bad Pig, you know, and then like DC Talk and whatnot, like Under the Table. But there used to be this band called Milan Lefevre, and he was like this hair metal dude. And this was in like late 80s and really early 90s, probably not even into early 90s, but they all dug him and his band, Milan. And later on in like 11th grade or 10th grade, when we started our first band, we were down in Atlanta. And Milan had broken up years ago. And we were down in Atlanta on like some weird trip. And we were working on this. We got this thing where we're like, there was a stage that was connected to a truck that we worked on. And the deal was, if we helped set the stage up every day and broke it down every day, they would give us a half an hour to play. So it was during the Olympics in 94, 96, whenever it was. And we were doing that. And it was weird because when we weren't playing, there was either some weird evangelical dude up there screaming at everyone like they were going to hell, or there was like all these washed up, like late 80s Christian rockers like doing their thing. So it was just funny to us the whole time. There's another story from the same trip where I saw a guy light a piece of wood in his hand by holding onto like an electrical socket, and it just burst into flames. But that's a whole nother thing. Oh, he also shot lightning bolts out of his fingertips. I shit you not. And so anyway, most of the because of those the Bible thumpers, that was like no one wanted near this, no one would come near the stage all day, you know. So one day we were set up in this huge parking lot. It was probably 200 square yards, like really gigantic, and there wasn't a soul in there. And it was like noon or one, and we just finished working. So me and John just walked out to the middle of this parking lot and sat down, and looking around at how funny it was that there was no one any within a mile of us, and this band was setting up on stage. And so years back, Milan Lefevre's greatest hit was Crack the Sky, right? And as this band is setting up, John's looking at him, and he's all, I recognize that guy for sure. Like, he's setting up his amp. And so he's like, I'm like, yeah, I don't know who that is. That doesn't look like anyone I know. He's like, no, I definitely know this guy. I definitely know this guy. And the guy gets up, and as soon as he gets up to the mic, John's like, that's Milan Lefevre, right? Like, he totally recognized the guy, but the guy had moved on and was obviously onto his adult contemporary thing and left his past behind him. So the guy sits, he gets up to the mic, and he says, hey, we're so-and-so. And John stands up in the middle of this parking lot and screams, play Crack the Sky, like as loud as he could. And you just saw this guy's spirit break. Like, it was the, like, there was no one for 2 miles except the one kid who recognized him from, like, his old life. And he just kind of, like, turned around and slumped down for, like, a few minutes. And then he came back and played the songs. But it, at the time, it was about the funniest thing I'd ever seen in my life, you know? So that's that story. But, we played that one. I'm sorry if you missed it. Oh, can I play Crack the Sky? No, I don't remember it. I can play Just Like Judas Kiss by Petra, but that's only because it's got a mean lick in it. But I can't do it on this guitar. Anyway. Okay.